evening and welcome to the Imagine Cruising World Indoor Bowls Championships 2024. We're live from Potter's Resorts in Hopton-on-Sea. Tonight we'll be watching our fifth and final Open Singles games of the day, which will see Scotland's Stewart Anderson play South Africa's Wayne Roberts. But for now, I will hand you back to Zach Patterson live in the arena.
Good evening, everybody, and thank you, Emily, for that marvellous introduction. First out this evening, we have a player making his debut here at the World Championships. He is a former national bronze, silver and gold medalist. Welcome out from South Africa, Wayne Roberts! Has four world titles to his name, including two former world singles champions. Please welcome out world number three, Scotland's Stewart Anderson. Throwing you back to the commentary box with Emily Ferguson and Darren Burnett.
Thank you for tuning in on day six of the Imagine Cruising World Indoor Bowls Championships. We've already seen four open singles games today with some great bowls being played, and I'm sure tonight will be no different. Joining me this evening is Scotland's Darren Burnett.
Yeah, good to be along here this evening. Obviously my good friend Stewart Anderson. Starting his
28 meters.
Singles campaign. Don't quite know so much about Wayne, but I know something, he's going to have to settle into the game pretty quick. Not sure if you've seen him play in any outdoor events, Emily.
Yeah, we actually met at the China and Hong Kong Open in 2019. I was there with Jason as well. Certainly a very steady bowler, but it's completely different on this portable rink, as you well know, Darren.
Yeah, absolutely. Still be a few people to come in this arena after their evening meal, so pace might just be slightly slower at the moment. Both players just coming up short with their opening deliveries.
Two and a half feet.
Correction here from Stewart this time. Certainly further. Still room though.
Yeah, Wayne will just be looking to get to Stewart's last one, rest on the inside of it.
Yeah, I think Wayne qualified out of Durbanville, which I believe is just outside Cape Town. Just overcorrected there. He's going to have to do something important with his last one, because I suspect he'll definitely be four down when he rolls it.
Thank you.
Yeah, it was good this time. Really good.
Forehand.
Yeah, really important. Wayne gets the right pace with this one. Doesn't want to start off.
Well, he's having a run.
He's going for a run.
He's on target. Oof, what a result.
Yeah. Excellent response, being four down.
Yeah, you know what? He hit exactly probably what he was aiming for. He then needed to rely on a bit of fortune, but hit the target well. He'll be delighted with that.
Set score 0-1 after first end.
You can see there was a lot of thought put into Wayne's nickname. I believe he's a plumber to trade, and therefore goes by the name Plumber.
Makes it nice and simple, doesn't it?
Yep.
Have you got any nicknames for Stewart?
I usually have to turn the mic off. That's
28 and a half metres.
So although Wayne escaped there with a great outcome with his last bowl, he won't want to be in these positions too often. Want to start the same bait up. Just push through it.
Yeah, great opening bowl here from Stewart. Just stepping in after Wayne missed his weight. And that first bowl in singles is so important, isn't it?
Yeah, certainly on this rink, if you can get one in nice and close, the in between 2 or 3 feet, 2 or 3 yards of weight shots, just about impossible. So you're forcing your opponent to either go very big or just try and get one nice and tight, close to the head, get a good second shot. Wayne's line's been good twice. He's went backhand, forehand. Almost a false start from Stewart there. Great line from Stewart again. He's trying to come round his own. Doesn't really want to finish alongside it.
Yeah, just unlucky there to give the head a bit more width.
Sticking with the draw for now. Still just needs to stop. I think he's pushed through it again. Grouping, but unfortunately just a yard too far.
Yeah, perhaps where Stewart wants to be now. Just matching those bowls up.
Oh, I think Wayne's shown his hand at the first end. He's not going to be frightened to let one go, so Stewart definitely needs to try and pass the jack. Does not want to make this wider.
That's exactly what he's done, unfortunately. Surely Wayne must be looking at that now and thinking it's worth playing through.
Oh, he's got to go at that. He's tried to draw it three times and it's been 3 feet through, so put a good run at the first end. Yeah, he's going again. He's on the wide side, he needs a help. He's got a help. It's hard to tell who holds the shot. Possibly one red. Not much in it.
Yep, Stewart here coming in for the shot.
Yeah.
A few more people arriving now. Must have finished their dinner.
Yeah, umpire, please.
Just a reminder for those unfamiliar with the format. It's sets right, of nine on. Ends.
Yeah.
If it's one apiece, yeah. We go to a three-end tiebreak. And with the singles as well, you've got the shot clock of 30 seconds. Each player gets five timeouts a game.
Two.
They get an additional one if it does go to the tiebreak.
Two shots, Stewart Anderson.
Set score 2-1 after two ends.
Yep, so the eyes were good. It was two.
Jacqueline, 27.5 metres.
Yeah, really good start here from Stewart.
Just gonna pull up just short. Wayne wasn't too bad again. Just a couple of feet short. Well, just needs to run. Might get second.
One red and a measure.
Adjusted, pushed out on a wider line.
Stewart here will just be hoping to get this ball through. If you can draw behind, that'll be perfect.
Yeah, just drawing in, even if he turns the jack himself first, even if he turns it 6 inches or so, it's only going to make it harder. He's to just bend now, his weight's probably decent. Not quite, I don't think. Best line, I would say. He's been on. It's all on pace. Can he stop? Great effort. Falls in.
Yeah, that's the winner.
One shot, Wayne Roberts.
A great last ball from Wayne.
Just 3 ends in a row. 2-2 after 3 ends.
His best delivery, his last one.
Jacqueline, 29 metres.
Needs to start getting his first bowl or two in a bit tighter way, and he's leaving a bit room, and Stewart will keep relishing that opportunity.
Yeah, Stewart at the moment's just piling them in.
By the look of the Stewart's face, it's obviously frustrated. The pace of the carpet has varied this tournament, there's no doubt about that, depending on what station you're playing. It hasn't been particularly fast at any point, so good adjustments from Wayne Nelt. Probably the only year I can say I've seen as many short balls played by players of this level, so it definitely is testing us. And I think Stewart's probably thinking he's been line shots, but not just quite as tight into the head as he normally would. Repeat of his last would be good. Going to make the trip, I don't think. Good effort.
Another chance for Stewart here. If he can just drag that jack through.
Yeah, I want to try and play this down the inside track if he can. He's got too much pace, it might not get back. Yep, there's it sitting by. Split the two red ones, not the worst bowl in the world. Really just a full draw for Stewart. Maybe trying to turn the jack a foot, make a two.
Good effort. Just not enough for the shot, though.
One shot, Wayne Roberts.
He was looking for a fifth ball there. He was trying to get himself back down to the mat.
That's got 2-3 after four ends.
He'd be delighted to be 3-2 up. He hadn't played two or three really good last bowls, then the scoreline could be very different. But at 3-2, he'll be happy with that.
Jacqueline, 29 metres.
Again, just missing a chance of his first ball.
Good from Stewart.
Yeah, just stepping in.
Yeah, if he's pushed this yet. He's certainly come down a narrow track. Just lacking.
One red.
Good here, Stewart. Wants to just get back to the centre of the jack. Perfect.
Yeah, well played. Two really good balls there.
Makes a big difference if you can sit right onto the jack, sort of hide it from your opponent's view. It's always a harder draw when you can't actually see the target. Just over adjusted here. First two just pulling up short and pushing through at least third. It's going to be another end where he's going to be having to play a big last ball. Three against him after this one comes down. No mistakes here. Not making the target any bigger either.
Yeah, well played, Stewart, and it finishes nicely behind as well.
Well, it's all in pace. He's got good pace, it will come back at the end. It's a good effort.
Not quite enough for the shot. Certainly gives something for
one
Stewart
red.
To aim at now, though. If he can tuck the jack through, rest the ball.
Yeah, definitely be arriving at this just over the pace. He can get sort of corner of the green ball and then the jack. He can make four. He's watching this closely. Has he got enough pace to get green ball or the jack? Well, made another, I think.
Two shots, Stuart Anderson.
Yeah, good shot from Stuart. A foot more pace, I think he would have had the perfect
score,
result.
4-3 after five ends. Jack length 28.5 metres.
Yeah, good win. Very good.
Yeah, it's just starting to settle a little bit more on the pace now.
Yeah, and that's what he needs to do. So just try and get two or three balls in as close as he can, give himself opportunities. Still very much set on here at 4-3. It's a good reply from Stewart, though.
Yeah, well played.
One red.
Good line from Wayne. Just needed to get round the red one and fall back. It's not a good ball in the head. Just drop inside, he'll be good. Yeah.
Two red.
Need a second shot. I think it's probably a runner now for Wayne. Forehand runner. Gets into the split of the two red balls.
Yeah, it's quite an inviting target now.
Yeah, he's trying it. Close. Well played. Very good. Did that very well. An absolutely excellent result. He's played his runners well. Turn two down into two up. Easy for Stewart here. There's not much of a target.
Time it.
Easier hand to draw on is the four hand because there's nothing in the way, but it's probably the harder hand to get the shot off of. Probably putting the forehand, you're probably trying to draw for second. Super effort. I think the ball will just stop him getting the shot though. Yeah, good second.
Yeah, really one good ball that. Like you said, it wasn't easy to get the shot, especially on the forehand.
No, I think Stewart had resigned his cell that, you know, he didn't want to drop two or three and, you know, just try and draw in as close as he could. That was the easier hand to do that on.
One shot, Wayne Roberts.
Set score 4-4 after six ends.
Well, it's certainly turning out to be an interesting first set here. So Stewart is definitely bowling more consistently, but Wayne is really converting. He's played a good few runners.
Yeah, and that's sometimes all it takes, you know. One or two big balls.
Jack length 28.5 metres.
Pulling underneath, which is very good. Can you reach Wayne? Just going underneath as well.
Well played there, Stuart. A question on the comments here. Throwing this over to you, Darren. What is the best piece of advice that you've ever been given that ultimately improved your game?
Yeah, well, probably had lots of advice over the years, to be honest. But, you know, I think when you come to these events, I think it's just trying to take your opportunity. You don't know if you're going to get many of them, you know, and a lot of people who have reached here, especially through qualifying events. I remember the years I did that as well. You know, you've worked hard to get here, so you just want to try and leave everything on that rink, give it your best shot. you know, and if you've got opportunities, then be positive and try and take them. You know, I think some players maybe come here and they're maybe a bit worried that, you know, the player shot and it goes wrong, but sometimes it's better to have done that than, you know, lost the game, maybe playing negatively. So, you know, and I think this year I've seen a lot of qualifiers who've been a bit like Wayne this match, not frightened to use the running ball. There's another pickle here.
Yeah, and this stage of the set is pretty important one, N7.
Oh, I think he's played that. I don't know what he was trying. I don't know if he was trying just to arrive down that tight line or if he's just underplayed it. Could be a big end, this. Stewart's line two. He'll be first and foremost trying to draw to make it three. If he does touch the jack at all, it's likely to be a full house. Just jinxed Wayne there, I think, because he has been really willing to play the running ball and he's played them very well. It might have been another occasion where he should have used it. Needs to stop. Oh, he's missed the chance.
Two shots, Stewart Anderson.
Yeah, I'd be disappointed with that. Sometimes those are spare shots. When you've got the final ball, you're holding anyway, you just need to draw in. They can be really quite game-defining, really. You've got to take those opportunities when you've got them.
Yeah, Stewart will be disappointed. Maybe just the lure of the four forced him to just overplay it. You know, maybe he should have just tried to draw for his three, and if he naturally was carrying a fraction of weight, he might have touched the jack for the four. But still, it's a double at the right time.
Jack then, 26 metres.
Suspect if Wayne wants anything out this set, he's probably going to have to win the last two ends. Yeah, good opener. Line's all over it. 7 or 8 inches short. Good reply, Wayne.
Yeah, really good ball that, just at the right time as well.
Forcing Stewart to switch hands. Well played. Three great balls. Draw just into this jack, Stewart, or if he can just slip round it.
Not sure he's quite got the pace, is he?
Well, he's certainly making the draw very difficult. Might be another occasion where there's only one green ball in there, but I feel Wayne has to score the end. Onus is on him to try and change this now. He is. He's going for it. He's just pulled it under. He needs luck. Wow.
Oh, I certainly didn't see that.
I certainly didn't see three red balls go out. It was probably a ball and a half under what he was hoping for. He got a maximum result.
Absolutely maximum.
Probably aiming to be off the high red ball and back in, really. That was his target. Got everything but his own. Yeah, just has to run. Line's all over this. Done it.
Well played, Stewart.
Yeah, it's a great bowl in the circumstances. I don't think he would have thought his three bowls would fly out there either.
Yeah, he's done well not to let that shot get to him.
Yeah, it's a perfect response to it. He's landed right on the jack. It's a toucher. So if it does go through to the back of the rink and stay within the boundary pegs, then it remains a live ball. We can already see Stewart has the deepest red ball on the rink as well. So difficult one here now for Wayne. He might be forced into trying to just... Very, very difficult shot, and not one you'd want to be playing, but he might just have to try and come onto the back of Stewart's bowl, try and spring the jack 2 or 3 feet. He's got one just waiting in behind it. Only other alternative is to try and play a perfect draw, but very difficult to beat Stewart's bowl. Forced into this very, very difficult shot. This will hook away. You can see it going quickly there. In fairness, he didn't have much
one
on.
One shot, Stewart Anderson.
Even with the pace he played it, I think he would have put it far too far.
Set to score 7-4 after 8 ends.
Just a slight buffer for Stewart at the right time in this set. Gives him a 3-shot lead going into the last end.
Jacqueline, 25 and a half metres.
Perfect opener when you're...
Well played, Wayne.
Excellent ball.
So he's slightly chasing this end. He does need a 3 to tie it or a 4 to win this set.
Yeah, to be honest, Stewart will not be flapping at this stage. He's got one in there within 5 or 6 inches. It's going to be an excellent end from Wayne to make a 3. All he wants to do is make sure he has an opportunity to play something. So I want to draw this one as close as he can, preferably maybe just a foot or so in behind. Just overplayed it slightly, but it is in behind. Difficult when you're faced with these tough last ends. 3s and 4s are not easy to make, and in the back of your mind, you feel you can't drop short because that just about eliminates every opportunity. Yep, Stewart will just come behind this, probably about a yard behind would be ideal. Good ball. Better effort from Wayne. It's not quite enough. Certainly going to make things pretty tough to make the 3 now. Ball here for Stewart. in the back corner. Make sure he secures the respot area.
Not too sure how Wayne's going to score a free hit.
Yeah, he doesn't really have much of a shot, to be honest. I think he's probably only hope would be to play maybe a foot 18 inches more than his last and hope somehow he could turn the red one out without moving the jack. Problem is, when she just pushes through it, it'll just sit there all day long.
One shot, Wayne Roberts. First set, Stewart Anderson.
Yep, so Scotland's Stewart Anderson there takes the first set, 7-5. And our live coverage wouldn't be possible without our sponsors, Imagine Cruising. It's not just cruises that they've got available though, they have rail journeys, package holidays and events. So let's have a closer look at why Imagine Cruising is more than just a cruise. Well, some of those places look spectacular, so don't forget to take a closer look on their website for more details. We've even got an exclusive offer for you of 5% off if you quote BOWLS24. Well, back with you then in this second set. Stewart managed to clinch the first one. He played well, some really good draw bowls. Wayne as well, he's playing decent. He's got some good running bowls in him. He's converted quite a lot, especially in the first couple of ends in that set. He found himself 4-3 down and managed to turn it around.
Yeah, he hung about in the set. We're playing big bowls at the right time. Consistency perhaps let him down slightly. Stewart certainly was the one that looked like scoring the majority of the counts. It's a reset now though, 0-0.
Well played, Stewart.
Sets up a bit of a target. An early runner here.
Just widening.
No. Timeout
called. Made me nervous then, I thought he was going to run the timeout.
Trying to sit right in the middle of these two balls. Make the drive a bit harder.
Stewart has three timeouts remaining.
Wayne can change his shot. He's got to go again. Trying to move some of them. Just wide.
Well, big chance here for Stewart Anderson to pick up a four on the first end.
decided to change his hand here.
Yeah, just dropped the pace. It was a good opening end for Stewart Anderson, though.
Yeah, I think he switched hands, possibly worried he'd come down and touch his own, but Stewart's weight control was always exceptional.
After first
slightly
end.
Surprised he moved off the backhand that he'd played so well that end.
Jack Glenn, 25 and a half metres.
Good opener again.
Well played, Stuart.
Missed his line way in. This is where the portable rink can punish you pretty severely. One or two balls inside the track and it finishes 6-7 feet under. Wouldn't normally have that effect on a stadium carpet where there's, you know, 6, 7, 8 rink stadiums. This your line, you'll go under, but you wouldn't normally go under as far as that.
Another chance for Stewart just to step in here. Yeah, absolutely nailing the line with all three.
He was on the better track, needs to run, perfect line, but it's going to pull up.
Yeah, still finds himself three down.
Yeah, he still finds himself three down and possibly makes the draw slightly more difficult because he's now going to have to try and come around his own front one.
Stewart here looking to run and cover.
Yeah, decided just to kind of cover these green balls at the back. Forcing Wayne to just try and find 2 feet on his last. Certainly drawable. Has to have good weight now and he'll pull back. Here it comes.
Yeah, really not far away here. Well played.
Yeah, great adjustment.
Yeah, very well adjusted. He really needed that, having missed the weight with his first three balls.
One shot, Wayne Roberts.
Set score 3-1 after two ends.
Yeah, he did not want to drop another three there, having lost the first set. It was a good last ball. Had a correction from his third, same line, just added that extra 2 feet of pace.
Jackman, 28 metres.
sneaks in. Yeah, good adjustment. Played it well.
Yeah, just managed to find that 2 feet.
Two red.
Does give Wayne a target to try and drop into. Down onto Stewart's last bowler, the jack. Needs to get back. Good effort. Unlucky.
Two, yes.
Unlucky not to save at least one. Carrying a bit of pace here, not going to get back from that line.
Domino effect there.
Rocked his back one in, I don't know if it's changed anything.
Yeah, I think it could be only one now.
Yeah, managed to get second by knocking his other ball in. Just lost his pace,
yeah.
One shot, Stewart Anderson.
Set score 4-1 after 3 ends. Jack Lynn, 26.5 metres.
Yeah, right on it.
Yeah, well played.
Tight track again. Kind of characteristic of the portable rink. It's quite a, until you get used to it, it's a strange thing that this, the centre of the rinks, the narrow lines, are actually the heavier part of the rink. Sometimes you go out on a wider track, it's actually, the pace is actually a bit quicker. So when you come down these centre tracks, you really do have to push through them. Better effort, slipping through the gap. Mm-hmm.
One red and a measure.
The second shot.
Yep, secured the second.
One
there.
Red.
It's a bit of a looser end this time from both players. Stewart got his first one in, but nobody's really done anything since.
Well played, Stewart.
Two red.
Yeah, unfortunately, Wayne's first one's now become a problem. He certainly can't go at this. It's probably forcing him into trying to just play the perfect draw.
Yeah, it's not an easy shot as well when he hasn't quite locked onto the pace this end.
No, when you're two down, you always want to make sure you reach.
Oh, it's not a bad effort.
Some effort. It's just going to fall down,
that's
though.
Really unlucky. Inches away from the jack, but he still finds himself two down.
Two shots, Stuart Anderson.
Set score 6-1 after four ends.
Yeah, he probably needed to find that ball a bit earlier in the end, and he might have then been able to take a bit more control of it. It remained pretty loose until Stewart closed it down with his last.
Jack Len, 25 metres.
This end is certainly an important one for Wayne to score. Just needs to latch onto that weight, build ahead and give himself a chance. But not easy when your opponent's putting in bowls like this.
Start this time from Wayne.
On green.
Try and add another.
Yeah, well played.
Very good. For Stewart in his first attacking bowl of the match. Forehand runner.
Yeah, both those bows will go.
He's under, he needs a good connection. Yeah, he'll be happy enough with that.
Goes on the re-spot.
A million miles off the target, but certainly probably was aiming for the green balls or the jack. Opened it up.
Still left quite a bit of room there for Stewart.
Yeah, much better track from Stewart. He's out on a wider arc. It's all on his pace now. This will come right back to the jack.
Yeah, well played.
I'll indicate, still on the move.
Trying the runner, doesn't want his own ball, doesn't want to take his own green, needs the jack. Good effort.
One shot, Stewart Anderson.
Set score 7-1 after 5 ends.
Well, Stewart just getting a little bit more daylight between him and Wayne. Only 4 more ends left of the second set. Wayne really needs to score this end.
Yeah, he needs to string a few ends together, I think, really. It's not going to be easy against somebody of Stewart's calibre.
Jack, and 27 metres.
Well played, turning the jack towards his own. It's a good effort, this.
Just to hold up. Okay, done enough of the shot there.
And a good ball from Wayne.
Oh, another great effort. Finishing well, it's going to be really hard for Wayne to score more than one. He doesn't want to risk turning the jack here.
Time out court.
No, he's in a bit of a dilemma. He's not got much to draw into. If he is drawing close to
Wayne
the end, he probably has to,
timeouts remaining.
To try and just come round the red balls and finish somewhere, you know, a foot behind the red balls would give him a ball in receiving position. His other option would be to stick this one very deep and make Stewart think about it. Tell you what, it's some effort. Just not getting back. Yeah, it's one of these ones, if Wayne wanted to score more than one, he'd probably have to go, you know, towards the re-spot area, somewhere in the back corner of the rink, and then it might have made Stewart think about what he was going to do. He might have to then try and cover. As it is, Stewart's just going to play the same draw as his last. If he can touch the green ball, the jack will spring enough. Just don't think he sent it.
No.
Yeah,
One shot, Wayne Roberts.
Set score 7-2 after six ends. Jacqueline, 28.5 metres.
Great opening bell there from Wayne Roberts. A two this end would be ideal for him.
Yeah, he needs six shots over the remaining three ends. Wrong side of it. Another ball in close though.
One green.
Just going to turn away.
The inside. It's a good effort. Another ball about though. Certainly not making it easy for Wayne to pick up a couple here.
Yeah, but putting somebody of Stewart's class in, this is about the only room you're going to get to make it count. He probably has to try and get in here. He's got a foot right round the jack. Probably needs a two. Doesn't want to get the outside of the red. No damage done.
One green.
Well, Stewart's playing this. He can win the match if he gets it right. Wants to get the red ball on the green. Well, he's made it and possibly made the shot.
Steam.
I think he's probably still made it. He was hoping to put the red onto the green. He would have scored the three shots he needs to end the match.
One shot, Stewart Anderson.
Still one at this stage. Makes it a very comfortable position for him.
Set score 8-2 after seven ends.
Seven shots over two ends is a tall order.
Jack line, 24 and a half metres.
Yeah, really strong opening bowl there from Stewart Anderson.
Good response.
One green.
That's a tight line from Stewart.
Yeah, I've not seen many of them.
Perfect spot now. That's what you've been trying to do, I think. Just slipping behind it. Yeah, it's not looking very promising for a score of 3, which is the minimum that Wayne would require on this end. Stewart will be round the back here, making sure he just gets slightly further than these two green bowls at the back of the rink. Make sure he's covered in both 3 spots, somewhere central. Just about end any hope.
Yeah, just about done enough there.
Lining up in the backhand. Not sure what Wayne's going to play here. Looks like he's just sticking with a draw. Resigned himself to not making anything.
One shot, Wayne Roberts, second set, and a match to Stewart Anderson.
Well, there we have it then. Stewart Anderson, our winner, having won the first set 7-5 and the second one 8-3. So let's have a little look at what we can expect tomorrow. Up first at 9:30, we have Les Gillett playing David Bolt, shortly followed by Mervyn King and Dylan Jacobs. Then at 2 o'clock, we see Greg Harlow play Alex Marshall, MBE. Well, thanks so much for joining us. That's enough for us. But let's have a little look on why Imagine Cruising is more than just a cruise.